Hi, good morning. I'm making this video today on hurt and forgiveness, two topics that are really close to everyone's heart. I got up this morning to a lot of questions by my students around forgiveness. Some people have the question, how can I forgive my partner if he has cheated on me? How can I forgive my boss for not paying my salary? How do I forgive a family member who stays in the same house but demeans me, calls me names, puts me down? I did so much for my friend. I was always there for her. But when the time came for her to stand with me, she wasn't there. How do you want me to forgive her? Does forgiveness mean acceptance? Does forgiveness mean agreeing to the other person's point of view? Does it not mean letting go of control? Does forgiveness mean staying with the person in the same house? Does it mean allowing the other person to carry on as he is? Would I not become small if I forgive? Or do I become the bigger person, as they say in Hindi, jo maaf karta hai, wo bada hota hai? Does it really mean that I become the bigger person, the more gracious person by forgiving? What is this whole concept, and why should I forgive someone? Why should I agree to what they were saying? They have wronged me. So I would like all of you to just close your eyes for 2 seconds and go back to a time where you felt really, really angry. The red hot ball of anger inside your stomach that made you feel very closed. Why do we get this angry? We get this angry because we are hurt. We are hurt by people, usually, who are the closest to us. People who we trust to be there for us. It could be family, it could be friends, co-workers, colleagues that you believed in. People who you thought were the closest to you. But what we forget is that we are projecting our own expectations onto these people. For example, you are a great husband and therefore you should do this, this and this. If you are a great wife, you should remember that it's our anniversary and behave in this kind of a fashion. You're my friend. How could you not show up on my birthday? You're my trusted colleague. But you left me in the middle of the project. Who decides what is right and what is wrong? We look at the world from the lens of our own belief systems. How we've grown up, what we think, how we believe, that is how we look at the world. So not being able to decide what is right and wrong, we hold on to our concept of right and that hurt and that anger and that feeling of betrayal and store it inside of us, because the moment we say we were wrong, of course we were not wrong. From our own perspective, we were not wrong. So the cycle of hurt, anger, resentment, holding on to all of this goes on sometimes for so long that the other person even passes away, and we are still holding on to all of that. And then in the spirit form, we are trying to make amends if it is our family. Being a medium, I see this very, very often. When I meet people for sessions, their heart chakra, their stomach, which is the solar plexus chakra, and their lower navel is sometimes gray and brown. And these are our three main emotional centers. This is where we store our hurt, our guilt, our anger, our resentment, the blame, and the feeling of being a victim. So if you have any issues related to these three areas, the heart, the stomach, and the lower stomach, probably you have some people in your life to forgive. Now let's go to the process of forgiveness. Let's talk about what is forgiveness. Forgiveness is not about accepting the other person. Forgiveness is not about saying that you were right and I'm wrong, or I was right and you are wrong. Forgiveness is about, A, it's an attitude. B, it is about letting go of the need of revenge. It is about releasing others and ourselves from that feeling of tightness, from that feeling of blame, from that feeling of guilt, from that feeling of not feeling good enough ourselves, and therefore keeping you in the situation of blame. It's a very simple exercise. The only thing that comes between us and forgiveness is, any guesses? Is our ego. The job of our ego is self-preservation. The job of our ego is to tell us that we are right and the other person is wrong. It is your ego that comes in between to tell you that why should you forgive? It was not your fault. But in any case, there is no judge or jury who can actually determine whose fault it is. It is actually the fault of our projections, our expectations from a certain relationship. That is your expectation of the relationship. Just because a friend did not turn up for your birthday party does not mean that he or she is not a good friend. Just because somebody stood you up on a date does not mean that it was his intent to hurt you. So when you release other people and yourself from your projections of what is right and what is wrong, forgiveness is a very easy exercise. So I want to quickly tell you about two techniques that I use with my clients. The one is in doing it in person, and the second is doing it when the other person is, you feel that the other person will not be receptive or you don't have the courage to be taking it face to face. So what you could do is that you could write a letter or a card to that person and actually post it to him, actually talking about your hurts, your grievances, but also owning up to your responsibility that I acted like this. I own up to this, that I acted out of control. I felt out of control for so many years or months or weeks. And I acknowledge that you are human and that it's okay. And I want to let it go. I want to let it go from my heart, from my life. I forgive the situation. I forgive my reaction to it. I forgive you. And I release both of us from this. Now, if you do it in person, let me tell you, it's extremely liberating. I've done it. But even if you want to do it over a card, an email, a phone call, or a message, it's equally effective. The second way is talking soul to soul. The practice of Ho'oponopono. For those of you who are not aware of this technique, please Google it and see. It's a beautiful meditation. It's a soul talking to someone's soul. So even if the person is alive and let's say in the same city, you sit in a quiet meditation and you call the other person's soul with your eyes closed. Imagine a huge ball of pink light or green light. These are the colors of the heart chakra. Expanding between the both of you and actually say that I forgive you. I forgive the situation. I forgive myself. Please forgive me. Yes, please forgive me is very important. And say thank you for showing up because I learned a soul lesson from you. Because you were not there when I needed you or I thought I needed you. I stood up for my own self in my own power, and that was such a revelation that I could do this myself. Thank you for showing up in my life. I acknowledge that you were in my life to show me your soul lesson. I thank you for my role, for your role in my life. I thank you for being there to play this part that I needed to see my own shadow or my own lesson or what was really hidden within me. You do this exercise, you close your eyes till the time you feel peaceful. You do this, you could do this over a few days as well. The final answer is that till when should you do it? You should do it till the time that the person's name or the situation does not trigger you. You don't get a reaction out of someone mentioning that person's name, or when you go through that experience in your mind, you don't feel triggered. So go through this. The last question I want to take up is, should we allow that person in our life? Allow is a word of the ego. There is no space for ego in forgiveness. My answer to this is that if your karmic retribution with that person is over, the person will disappear from your life on his own. If not, then there are some other lessons that need to be learned. Does it mean that you stay in abuse? Any kind of abuse, emotional abuse, physical abuse, just because you want to forgive someone? No. You decide your own life path. whether you want to stay in that situation or you want to move away from that situation is absolutely in your hands. Should you look out for another job? Perhaps yes. Should you be in a relationship that is causing you emotional abuse, even though you've forgiven the other person, the person continues this trend? Probably the lesson for you is courage. To pick up your courage, talk to the other person, explain to him post forgiveness that this is the pattern and these are my boundaries and I would like to be respected. And if there is a repetition of this pattern, I'm going to feel disrespected and therefore move on. So forgiveness doesn't mean that we are going to be stuck in the same relationship or the same situation. It means forgiving the situation, being compassionate, understanding that other people are also humans. But please feel free to take the path that is meant for you, that your soul says is okay for you. Forgiveness does not mean accepting something wrong over and over again. It means removing yourself from that situation, not blaming the other person. Sometimes there's a situation where you have to stay in a family. You're not immediately connected to that person, but you have to stay in the same family. And therefore it's fine. You kind of don't come in the other person's way. He doesn't come in your way or she doesn't come in your way. And you continue to go on your paths and your destinies till the time the person doesn't trigger you, till the time it does not hurt you, it does not bother you, it does not interfere with your free will. It's okay for other people to be. Forgiveness is sometimes one-sided. It's okay. Don't forgive with the expectation that I've forgiven you, now you forgive me, or you apologize and you say sorry. No. You're doing this for your own self. Please remember that. I'll be happy to take any questions. You can post them to us on www.soul-miracles.com. That's my website. Or ask me on my Facebook page. That's also called Soul Miracles. I'll be coming soon with another video. Thank you.